Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, I just thought that I would make kind of a casual video just taking you through my day running my Etsy shop. And I just want to put out there, if you're expecting like a really nice office space and a really pretty kind of setup, you're not going to get that here. We have been running our shop for about 2 months now, so we don't have like a really nice office space set up right now. We are working with what we have. But the reason I kind of wanted to show you this, even though it is far from perfect, is because I believe that things don't need to be perfect in order for you to start. And I think if you just see somebody else running their Etsy shop and everything looks beautiful and they have this beautiful office and they've put all this money into it, then maybe that would kind of deter you from starting and you would put it off until, you know, the future when all of that stuff can be possible for you. But I want you to get started as soon as possible. I am a firm believer in just starting now, starting with what you have now and what you can work with right now, because that allows you to start making sales and learning and making mistakes and getting better and bringing some money into your business so that you can, you know, fuel your business. You can invest in a nicer office space and all of that stuff. Today is kind of just a normal day in the business. We have 13 open orders and we're probably gonna get about half of those out today. So we're gonna be doing a lot of packaging and product fulfillment. But we are also testing some new products, so that's a lot of fun. And we also need to make some products, but that will be later tonight. Yeah, so let's just get right into it. If you aren't subscribed to this channel, please make sure and do that. My name is Brittany and I share tips and strategies to help you start and grow the handmade shop of your dreams. Also, real quick, I just want to say down below in the description, I have linked a free Etsy success checklist for if you are just getting started on Etsy and you want to make sure you have everything in place to see rapid success with it. That is linked down in the description. And I also have linked in the description my private Facebook group for handmade shop owners to come together, ask questions, get some support, some personalized support on your Etsy shop and on everything related to running a handmade shop. So if you want to join that and join our little community, then head down to the description and join that. But let's just get into how I run my handmade shop. Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to do today is work on fulfilling orders. So just packaging everything up and getting it ready to ship out. The post office closes at 4:30 and it's already like 1:30, so gotta get a move on that because there is a lot that goes into packaging. And if you are a new Etsy seller and you haven't made any sales yet, I really encourage you to consider your packaging and shipping before you even open up shop, because it is a much bigger part of the process than you might think and you might expect. Because when somebody orders a product from you, you don't just want to ship them their item in a box. You want to make it pretty, you want to make it branded and fun for the customer. So that's what I'm going to be doing, and I will show you kind of how we do that and what we include in our package and all of that stuff. Okay, so remember when I said that things were not going to be perfect? Yeah, so this is our whiteboard and it is very unappealing to the eye, but it works for us. It has both of my handwriting and also Rio's handwriting, who is my partner, and we run this shop together. But yeah, let me just show you kind of what's going on here. So we record our 7-day conversion rate and revenue, and we also record the open orders that we have at any given time. Our weekly conversion rate and revenue is extremely low this week. Won't get into that, but yeah, normally it is about double that, but that's where we're at this week. And then we also have like important dates coming up. So we can keep track of that and know what we're working towards. We always have written down materials that we need. We have like a to-do list, and then we have the current amount of bath bombs that we have, and then the amount that are needed for the open orders that we currently have. So we just use this to kind of communicate with each other and keep track of what's going on in our business. This is our little space where we store all of the bath bombs that are waiting to go out. We have a dehumidifier here because it is humid here in Texas and these bath bombs can get like weird and bumpy if there's too much humidity. So actually These ones are looking pretty bumpy, so I think we're gonna need to get another dehumidifier. There's a lot of like problem solving that goes into this, and like things coming up that you need to address and fix just constantly. So that is one of those things. Then we have our oils and our infused oils up here. We normally have some oils infusing, some herbal infused oils going on back there. Right now we don't, but yeah, so that's just kind of what's going on here. And yeah, this is what works for us right now. So this little table over here is where all of the magic happens. I know it is not the prettiest, not the most exciting, it's just a little table, but this is where we make all of our bath bombs. This is where we package everything up. This is where we test new formulations. This is just where the magic happens in our business. Okay, so I am making a separate video all about Etsy shipping and just going through how to fulfill your orders and ship them out and all of that stuff. So I'm not going to get too into that in this video, but the first thing that I am going to do is print out the packing slips for the orders that we are getting out today so that we know exactly what is going to be in the package and what I need to package up. So I'm going to go into Etsy and print those packing slips. Okay, so I just went ahead and grabbed the different size boxes for the orders that we are shipping out today. We are shipping out 7 orders today. So there are a few different size boxes that we need because people ordered, you know, different quantities of bath bombs. So that is something you need to keep in mind before you start selling, is that you're going to need to have different size boxes because people are going to order different quantities of items. And that might seem obvious, but it's easy to forget things like that when you're just starting out. So okay, so I have all of these boxes together and the tape actually worked super well, so I'm happy about that. But now I have all of the packing slips that I am shipping out today, and I'm going to put them in the corresponding box. And then what I'm also going to do is write the name for each order on these little pieces of paper and just stick them in the boxes so that I can keep track of whose order is whose. So now that these boxes are prepped and ready for the bath bombs, we are going to use the packing slips to add in the correct bath bombs. So this is how we package up our bath bombs. We wrap them in cheesecloth and in hemp twine and with a little label attached. So this is what I have been doing for a while, but I still have some more to go. Basically what this entails is cutting the cheesecloth into squares of 9 by 9 and then cutting strips of hemp twine that are about a foot long. And then I have to cut these labels into the circle shapes that they are, and then cut a little hole so that we can put the hemp twine through it and do that. So it does take some time, and it works best if I do it like in batches. So like if I work on just the labels for a really long time and get a bunch of those done so that I have, you know, a stack of labels over here, and then I cut a bunch of hemp twine so that I have hemp twine ready to go, and same with the cheesecloth. And it just works better to do one job at a time rather than doing like everything all at once. Okay, so the last thing that I include in the packages is these business cards that just say the name of my business, and then they also say our Etsy shop and our Instagram. So I include one of these in each package. And then if it is a first-time customer, we include this little note, which just lets the customer know how they can reuse or recycle each of the materials in the package. And also lets them know that if they leave a review, we will send them a 15% off coupon for their next order. And if it is a return customer, which none of these ones are, we include a separate card, which just basically lets them know they're in our rewards program and what that entails. So we have our business card, and then we have this little flyer. We have the packing slip in there, and then all of the products are cushioned with the shredded paper. Sorry about this lighting. It is quite a bit later in the day, so we ended up kind of scrambling to get everything done before the post office closed. Sometimes it just works out that way, especially since I was trying to film videos and also get the packages ready to ship out. It took me about 3 hours to package those packages, and like I said, that took longer because I was filming as well. But just putting it out there, if you're a new seller, be prepared to spend a lot of time on packaging. And also, like I said in the beginning of the video, there are things that we can do to like streamline that process so it doesn't take as long. But as new sellers, this is just how we're making things work right now. Now what I need to do is I need to retest a formulation for my wildflower bath salts and fill some sample bottles with those. And then later tonight, I think we will be making more bath bombs, and we usually do that after my daughter goes to bed, so around 8 o'clock at night. We're working around, you know, having a toddler, and my partner has a full-time job as well. That's why I said in the beginning of this video that this isn't going to be like inspiration video as far as like everything is beautiful and perfect and like this is like your goals, but this is just kind of how you have to start things. And this is just like, if you just get started, it's gonna look kind of messy like this. It's gonna be kind of all over the place, and you're gonna be having to figure things out and make things work and getting creative. So yeah, but if you know, just go for it like we did, you can start getting some money coming in, and then you can use that money to grow and, you know, get that efficient setup that you want and hire employees and, you know, quit your job so you can do this full time and all of that stuff. So I think I'm gonna end this video here. I think you pretty much got the gist of how our days go. And yeah, so hopefully you found this in some way, shape, or form inspiring or informative or whatever. And don't forget to hit subscribe if you run a handmade shop or if you are looking to start one. And please join my Facebook group. I'm really excited about it, and I really want to build this community so we can actually interact with each other and I can actually know who you are on the other side of this camera. And also, if you want to get my Etsy success checklist, it is always linked in the description. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.